It took me 2 years to figure out why I had inconsistent extrusions on my Cetus Mark III, but only two simple parts to make the machine print better than most of my other printers. This problem might not be unique to the Cetus, but also affect your printer. Let's find out more. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan and welcome to CNC Kitchen. This video is supported by our own lineup of threaded inserts for 3D printing, which is finally available in many EU countries on Amazon. We have standard size metric inserts as well as quarter inch ones for your camera projects and short versions if you're working in tight spaces. If you want to support what we do over here and want to lift your 3D printing projects to the next level, check our inserts using the link in the description. This is my Cetus Mark III that TierTime sent me more than 2 years ago, and I do feel a bit bad that I never reviewed it. The Cetus was praised by many at that time for great print quality and all linear rails construction. Unfortunately, I never really liked it. Well, let's say I liked the idea of a minimalistic machine, but their control board running proprietary firmware, an oversimplified slicer, noise, and only okay print quality drew me away from it. I always felt that it could do better when seeing it on my shelf, so I thought I'll bring it back to life by simply replacing the control board and this way fixing all of my issues. I'll cover this endeavor in an upcoming video, so if you want to learn how you can also simply revive an old 3D printer, put, in my case, a Mellowfly E3 with Wi-Fi, silent stepper drivers and RepRef firmware with input shaping in it, make sure to be subscribed. In this video though, I'll show you how I was able to fix my extrusion inconsistencies, because they were not solved by the new mainboard I put in it. In the end, the solution was obvious, but it took me a while to get there. The fix was super simple, hence I thought I'd make a quick video about it. Let's start at the beginning. What do I mean when I talk about inconsistent extrusions? Well, simply put, surfaces that should look regular and smooth have this rough texture. One layer seems to be thicker than another one, or they just don't line up properly, which makes prints look especially bad if you inspect them at the right angle. After trying this and that over the last 2 years and never making it really better, I finally took the time and approached it systematically. I thought about how the phenomenon might be generated and what the causes for it might be. The inconsistent extrusions or layers that I saw on my prints might be from inconsistent layer height, where thinner layers are squished more to the side than thicker ones. Then there could be play in one or more of the axes, which would cause layers to not line up properly. And finally, there's inconsistent flow from the hot end. Let's quickly talk about reasons and solutions for all of them. I can't go into super details, because then this video would end up being hours long, but if you're interested in a specific topic, or even encountered one yourself on your machine, or if I forgot something, then leave a comment down below. First, inconsistent layer heights. This might come from a not smoothly running C-axis, if maybe rollers are too tight or too loose. The Cetus uses linear rails, which I even disassembled to make sure that everything runs fine. Z-wobble is another phenomenon that can happen if you have a crooked C-axis. Z-wobble though shows a very regular pattern in the Z-direction, which wasn't the case on my parts, plus the Cetus uses a belt-driven Z-axis, which usually doesn't show these artifacts. As I've shown in a previous video, a badly tuned heated bed can also cause a pattern very similar to Z-wobble, but since the Cetus doesn't use a heated bed, this can't be the reason for my problems either. Then there are the, in my opinion, controversial magic layer heights, as some call them. This basically means that you should choose a layer height that is a multiple of a full step of the Z-axis motor to avoid problems if micro-stepping doesn't work perfectly. This didn't make a difference on my machine, maybe also because the TMC2209 drivers installed do a pretty good job with microstepping in stealth job and spread cycle mode. I even measured the positioning accuracy of the Z-axis with a dial gauge at different layer heights, which all showed that the tolerance is below 1/100th of a millimeter. Nothing made a significant difference in print quality, why I concluded that my problems are probably not caused by inconsistent layer heights. Next, play in the X, Y and extrusion axis. This is something that is more common than one might think and usually caused by the grub screws on the belt pulleys coming loose over time, which causes play between the shaft of the stepper motors and the pulleys. This can cause weird artifacts on prints, mainly with layers being slightly shifted from time to time. Well, the Cetus uses press fit and glued pulleys on all motors, so this wasn't obviously my problem. Similar to loose pulleys, you might also have a hot end that wobbles around, either because the bolts holding it are loose or the nozzle isn't tight. I checked both on my machine, where everything was properly tightened. Let's finally get to inconsistent flow from the hot end, and this is probably the broadest topic. First, if your filament diameter is constantly varying, of course, extrusions won't be constant either. Nowadays, this is usually not a problem anymore, but I still tried different brands and rolls, which didn't change a lot. Then there are the print settings themselves. Especially during speed changes, you can often see under extrusion when the print head accelerates and over extrusions when decelerating, just because the extrusion system always lags a bit behind. This can quite simply be checked if you just print the model really slow where the hot end has enough time to be in line with the movement. If you're running a more current firmware, linear advance or pressure advance also try to minimize that phenomenon. Though, regardless of how slow or fast I printed or how I tuned pressure advance, the pattern stayed the same. At that point, there wasn't that much left, and I looked at the extruder itself. The Cetus uses a super simple direct extruder without a big heatsink or complex gearing and pretensioning system, which works better than one might expect. But due to the lack of pretensioning solution, you can't really control how much the filament is pressed onto the extruder gear. If it slips or strips, the extruded material won't be proportional to the rotation of the extruder motor. I tried different extrusion temperatures and extrusion speeds, which didn't change anything, and even the imprinted pattern on the filament looked fine. I even changed and removed the Bowden tube that feeds the filament to the extruder because I thought this could also cause additional drag in the system, but no change in the results. More or less the only thing left was the feeding system itself. The Cetus uses a custom extrusion gear that is directly glued onto the shaft. I manually moved the motor as fast as possible with some G-code, and there it was. The extrusion gear wobbled on the shaft, not because it was loose, but because the bore of the extrusion gear was off-center. This causes a serious problem, because that makes the gear rotation and filament feed not linearly proportional anymore. If the gear is wobbly, the extrusion radius constantly changes. Over one rotation of the gear, the extrusion amount is not constant, but varies, causing extrusion inconsistencies. Unfortunately, the extrusion gear on the Cetus is custom and glued, so not easily replaceable. I tried grinding it down, but due to the amount of wobbliness, I basically removed all of the teeth on one side of the gear, rendering it useless. Because I was out of options, the only thing left was trying to replace the gear. Removing it was simpler than I thought, and by carefully using a blowtorch and a flathead screwdriver, I was able to remove the existing one. I still had a bunch of my old extruder gears lying around, but the ones currently popular on many Bowden style printers are 11mm in diameter, in comparison to the stock 10mm one on the Cetus. So by replacing the old gear, I couldn't use the old idler anymore and had to design a new one using Fusion 360 with some reference dimensions plus a photo. The first version looked pretty much like the old one, also relying on the flexibility of the part for pretension. I tried different materials and noticed that this isn't an optimal solution, so I added a small pretension spring that should make everything more reliable. I printed the first idler from PLA out of laziness, but that got too soft due to the heat of the stepper motor. I've now been using PETG for a while, and that worked flawlessly. STL and CAD files are available in the description. I'm usually not a big fan of modding a printer until there isn't anything left of the original machine, but with this simple replacement, the print results are now just shy from perfect. Of course, these results are now also with the updated mainboard, but I'm quite certain that the electronics update mainly helped it to make it basically silent and way easier to use with RepRap firmware. Now, I don't want you to rip out the extrusion gears from your various printers and blame bad printing quality on them. though it might still be worth the time checking your extruder gears if your print results look strange. And maybe there's another point on the list that I talked about that might be the reason for your problems. This was honestly the first time that I thought about the possibility that the extruder gears might play such a significant role for the print results. I'm not sure how widespread this problem is, but maybe there are more badly manufactured extruder gears out in the wild. So if you have encountered something similar on your machine, please leave a comment down below. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you found this project interesting. If you want to support my work, consider becoming a patron or YouTube member and check out the other videos in my library. I hope to see you in the next one. Auf Wiedersehen and goodbye. And blame bad.